If you ever ask yourself if you have a purpose and a meaningful life, I'm pretty sure you're asking that because you doubt the certainty. If you think there is an answer to that, or you contemplate if there's a solution to the problem you're struggling with, so you don't suffer from it eternally till you die. And from the hours that become days, they entail these uncertainty of saying, why do I live? Is there a reason, you know? Like, and I think I can speak English now so you can understand, which is to say the most, you don't matter, because you are a living thing. You see, no offense, but everything is meaningless in their own yet universal way. So I will say it in English again so you understand. Since I can't talk like a normal person, God sakes. You're alone, and so is everybody. But that's why you're still alone. Mentally. But in your case, physically. By the way, be sure to like the video. And so, that was an intro, believe it or not. Yeah. Leave in the comment if you like it or not. So, yeah, another plethora of philosophical realm to unravel for today. And I personally think this one is a good starter for those in the shallows of the ocean. That is the school of thought. I mean, philosophy. Yeah. And the school of thought is on how you don't matter and your life is inherently dumb. You probably thought so. So, you've already been spoiled. Now, the fruit doesn't fall from the tree. And with the same logic, bombs don't fall from far from the sky. Where was I going with this? Three core ideas are existentialism, absurdism, and nihilism. And you know what? I am all three. And you know what? I can walk you through this maze. And let's go in and reverse alphabetical order, because fuck A to Z. Nihilism. Nihilism is the absence of reason to live. Okay, hope you understood that. Because basically, nihilism says no to the validity of other philosophies as a methods to live. And nihilism says they're inherent. Why might a nihilist live on then? They're pessimistic. Why? They might have to just die, right? Because death is meaningless too. Or in a way you can understand, or better, life is still alive without the reasons why. You know, life can still be lived. You see society, which is not real, just a community of communities. You know what, it's like putting a bag of trash inside a bag of trash. I didn't intend that, but the trash inside it makes it humanity, and that's why it's called a trash bag. If it wasn't a trash bag inside a trash bag, it wouldn't be called a trash bag inside a trash bag. Fuck. Without trash, it simply wouldn't be a trash bag. Yeah. Therefore, along the same lines, meanings won't exist after humans are extinct. Because reasons, they never really existed at all. They're like, God, we made them up. Fuck, I gotta edit that down. Why did I say that? I mean, if you're asking why nihilists are still alive when they don't even have the reason to live, I mean, look at the animals in the wild. They don't have 9-to-5 jobs, nor do they live with the purpose to dominate the continent of Europe or shit. or become a billionaire just to purchase a golden tombstone for me to spit on. You don't see kids asking those wild animals why they haven't committed suicide yet, or why are they doing, what are they doing there? You know, but just, you do you, boo. And then, existentialism. Existentialism is my favorite cherry on top of the cake, called dread. You probably had that before. because it makes the dish 99% cherry. The rest of the cake, the leftovers are served again to the next person who comes to swallow the cake. And the restaurant that serves the cake is called the Pentagon. Wake up, you fucking sheeps. Okay, so my mom said I can't say that. Sorry about that, guys. Anywho, where was I? I don't think I was too far away, but... existentialism. See, I found my way back faster than you can say money isn't real. God, where was I again? Existentialism. So yeah, basically, fuck your whole life. Just kidding. Of course, existentialism doesn't scream that you don't matter. Like, that was just a clickbait. I paraphrase it, however, because I knew you would understand the gist. Because you would think so. Don't ask me why, ask yourself. Anyways, it's just a thought that fell from the apple. The analogy I mentioned before. It's the thought that fell from the apple, that fell from the tree. As I mentioned before, in which the seed within grew up to be a tree to drop apples. Again, like, which I'm mentioning now. Just tell that it's a different tree I'm talking about. Oh, I'm recording, okay. Yeah, remember the bomb analogy? The bomb doesn't fall far from the sky. You know, where the incident wasn't your fault for the loss of the innocent children? No, not like that. That's not existentialism, but rather it's a severe PTSD. But what I'm saying is, they're practically the same. Yeah. What the fuck is different with nihilism and existentialism? Why the fuck am I here? Why am I not dead already? anyways, existentialism is knowing there is no meaning, I mean zero meaning, in living on, but it's with the twist that differentiates this from complete nihilism. Existentialism says zero two is a number. Now, like, therefore, no reason can be no reason can also be a reason for the certain condemned circumstance. And existentialism says that make your own meaning, because you might as well do so, since there is also no reason not to. Like, it just fucks with your brain. Absurdism. Absurdism argues that there is no meaning, so... but also for one to live, there must be a defiance to combat the silent nothingness. You know what the fuck that means? So that defiance comes into play, and that becomes a reason for one to keep on breathing and running, like, to live. So, like, life is absurd, and embracing the weird is the only thing a man can do when he can't do anything else than that. Obviously. What the fuck am I saying? But, you know, as a prisoner in a temporary farce, you will never discover who you are as a person. That's a childhood myth adults tell. Just so you can go to sleep. What do I have? What do I talk about? Divorce. Anyways, so you will never discover who you are as a person, and it won't kill you to be devoid of having within the answer to the answer with query. You are the unknown, you know, like, and any false idea beyond it is only pretending to be a true idea for our identity. I think that's what absurdism says, the face of life's identity. Life's identity, what the fuck? That's how I translated. So yeah, you don't matter, but that's the only certainty we have now. And how comforting is that? The other certainty is death, not to mention, but that's almost a given. So we're gonna exclude that from the praise of misery. Yeah. Personally, I know you didn't ask, but I need to finish the video. I don't think you should think on philosophy as the prime route to take to live and die by. There is no alpha philosophy superior over another, and instead they're all just valid. They're all invalid. They're all ideas. Who knows if they're real or not? And knowing you don't matter is the only humanism motto that isn't bogus or bullshit. Let's be honest, I don't think you're gonna believe in coping skills or life is worth it. Right? You're like, you are loved, self-care, you're never too young to grow up from that. Grow the fuck up. But hey, nothing matters. So, that means I do care about you, I guess. Happy birthday, and sleep soon.